In this video series, I'm going to be dissecting the entire real estate purchase contract in Arizona so that you can have all the information ahead of time and you'll have no surprises when placing offers. It's Steve Dooley. This video is going to be quick as we dive into page zero of the contract. And this page is one that many agents out there just plain overlook or disregard in general. It is page zero, so it's not actually a part of the purchase contract. However, there is a ton of useful information there that is of very much high importance to buyers. So let's dive in. Okay, this is the very first page you will see. This is the Arizona purchase contract, and it says right here, attention buyer. And actually, when you submit offers, you are actually, your agent rather, should be checking off box all these boxes with check marks, and this is submitted with the actual purchase contract. So right now in this video, I just want to dive into this particular page, and because there's some important pieces of information that are, again, are often overlooked. So it's just really good information for the buyer. So number one, read the entire contract before you sign it. So that should go without saying. It's a legal document and it's very important. That being said, many people kind of glaze through it, look at the bullet points, and solely rely on their realtor as the expert, when in reality, the responsibility is that of the buyer. Number two here, review the residential seller property disclosure statement. Now, this information does come directly from the seller. However, as we dive into this contract, we'll find out that this particular, it's called the SPUDS, S-P-D-S, that particular document may or may not be provided before you place the offer. Some agents placed it on MLS so people can download it ahead of time, and others do not. It is not required to give to the buyer prior to placing the offer and getting into contract. So number three here is review the inspection paragraph, which is section 6A, which we'll be diving into, and make sure you're hiring qualified inspectors. And again, your agent should be reviewing this with you prior to even getting to this point where you're actually placing offers, and hopefully in the form of a buyer consultation. Number four, you should have the ability to obtain homeowner's insurance, because that is required as part of the contract that you, especially if you're using, it's actually only required if you're using a loan, but if most people are, and if you are, then it is required. Number five is kind of after the fact. Hopefully, if you're getting to the point where you're placing offers, you are already at least pre-qualified for a home loan or a mortgage. Obviously, this says if you haven't done so, provide your lender with the requested information. And that should be the very first thing you do, you know, when your whole buying process is getting pre-qualified for your loan. This one's super important, very often overlooked. And many agents don't even realize what this is. So read title commitment within 5 days of receipt of it. So what the title commitment is it's a document issued by the title company. The seller is, it's insurance that the seller will provide a clear title report, meaning that there are no liens or any other things on the title. So it is insurance for your lender to ensure that they receive a clean title. Read CC&Rs and other governing documents. Other governing documents would include things like the HOA bylaws and things like that within 5 days of receipt, especially if the homeowner's in the homeowners association. So many people overlook this, and CC&Rs are like 20 pages of a lot of legal verbiage. But at the end of the day, it is the buyer's responsibility to go over those. A good agent will provide those and give you insight into how to read those and things. But at the end of the day, that is part of the buyer due diligence. And conduct a pre-closing walkthrough. If the property is unacceptable, speak up. So the pre-closing walkthrough is important. It is not required. However, it is strongly suggested that you do it. Either way, you are required to do some paperwork on it. There's actually a checkbox on the form that says you elect to not do the walkthrough if you so choose. So you can, you know, forego it if you want. It's always a good idea to go back through the house and kind of put eyes on it right before you close. So we'll dive into all these things. And some of these are mentioned in the contract. Many of these 1 through 8, you know, should have been addressed prior to even getting to the point where you're looking at a contract and writing an offer. So hopefully you have a great agent who is helping you with that. One other thing I want to mention on here is they talk about wire fraud. Wire fraud's a thing. And again, do not ever wire any money without verifying 100% that that money request is sent from the proper person, because a lot of that fraud, it does exist. So there's like 9 bullet points on there on this page 0. Hopefully that gave you a little bit of information. If you haven't already done so, be sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and then watch the next video in this series where we dive into page 1 of the contract. Talk to you soon.